Bonjour à tous, je m'appelle Emile Grace Lloyd, je suis une auteure d'un roman qui sort bientôt, à mi-mars, je crois. I'm American, although I was a student here in France many years ago, and so I speak a little bit of French, although sometimes more French than others. The novel that's coming out here in France is about a young widow who is still quite in love with her husband and who is trying to keep this love alive. That's part of her work, to garder cet amour. She is also a landlady, a propriétaire of a small apartment building. What's interesting is that she's a very introverted woman and wants very much to have solitude and privacy, but at the same time she chooses to be a landlord, so it gets into that tension of how much we can secure our privacy, how much we can be alone with others, how much we live in private, how much we live in public, and how much we can control events around us in an apartment building or even in our own home. And much of the novel is about that tension between how much we surrender to life and how much we try to control it. And in the case of this small apartment building and with Celia as the landlady, first thing that happens is one of her tenants moves out because he wants to take a sabbatical in France, and why not? And she sublets, sous louer, c'est ça? De l'appartement au-dessus, to a woman named Hope, an older woman who's just left her husband because he's fallen in love with another woman. Terrible thing, but it happens. And Hope begins a rather noisy affair with a man, and this takes Celia, it causes her to travel a bit into her own past, the loss of her own husband, and some violent encounters that she had sexually as a way to anesthetize herself from the loss of her husband several years ago. So when Hope moves in and starts this rather noisy affair, she becomes fascinated because she sees something in Hope she identifies with. Celia's in her 30s, Hope is a bit older. At the time that I wrote the book, I was the literary and fiction editor at Playboy. Now, people find that très excitant, but finalement, c'était vraiment pas pour moi. C'était vraiment, je l'ai fait pour la cause de la littérature, parce que Playboy a une tradition assez grande. Au passé, il y avait Nabokov, il y avait Saul Bellow, Nadine Gordimer, Ursula Le Guin. Joyce Carol Oates, qui toutes ces écrivains ont écrit pour Playboy. Et j'étais intéressée à Playboy pour ça. But it's funny, when I tell people I work there, they think, oh, did you put sexy stories in the magazine? No, indeed I did not. They could be very provocative stories. We could actually push the envelope, as we say in English. Can you say that? Pousser l'enveloppe, ça n'existe pas en français, non? That just means to be more provocative sexually, say, than The New Yorker could be. But the reason I was drawn to working there is because so few places in the United States anymore publish short stories, histoires nouvelles, in magazines anymore, because magazines are becoming so thin. But the job required me to be out in the world very much, at parties, calling people, persuading people to Playboy, despite the women in the magazine, all of the images. And I was drawn to this story about this introverted widow because I got to be inside a world that, at least in theory, was structured and was about the interior life more than this life that I felt was very exterior and persuading writers and dealing with agents, literary agents. And I wrote, I had to write because my job kept me quite busy. I worked very long hours. I wrote a lot of the novel on the subway or on the weekends. And I didn't tell a lot of my writers. I work with writers like Margaret Atwood and James Elroy, Jess Walter, wonderful writers. I didn't tell them all that I wrote. I wanted to keep it a little bit of a secret because I wanted to make sure I put their work first. I didn't want them to think I was a dilettante. Now that word does exist in French, yes.